University of North Carolina is not just an athletic powerhouse with dedicated fans. It's also a top-tier academic institution. But one academic counselor there, who spent years tutoring student-athletes, says too many of them can't even read.
I mean, we may as well just go over to Glenwood Elementary right up the street and just let all the fourth graders in here, the third graders in here.
Now, I know what you might be thinking. Is she actually an academic counselor for this university? What did these athletes do to get her so upset? Is she exaggerating? Or she can't be serious, right? Well, according to a HuffPost article, the U.S. illiteracy hasn't changed in 10 years. 32 million adults are illiterate, 14% of adults read at a level below basic, and 29% read at a basic level. This data came from the National Assessment of Adult Literacy, a nationally representative assessment of English literacy among American adults age 16 and older. Since 1992, adults have been tested on their literacy levels once they turned 16. In order to narrow down where adult literacy begins to change, 4th, 8th, and 12th graders were tested each year to see the average scores among each grade. Based on this table, the average literacy scores begin at 0 and are capped at 500, being the high score, and the average scores since 1992 to 2015 are graphed. Scores remain about the same throughout the years, and the gaps between grade level average literacy scores decrease as students reach a higher grade level. The 10 years, 2000 to 2010, mentioned in the article of HuffPost, is visible in the graph because no rise or decrease can be seen for the average 12th grader's score throughout the years. During 12th grade, the students are considered adults and have an average score slightly under the basic level, a score of 300. This data led our team to dig deeper from a national scale to a state scale to see the literacy among Californians.
Reading comprehension is a student's ability to understand what they read, and it's becoming more and more complicated for students to understand each year. Yearly, students fail to reach their grade level reading standards. Such low reading comprehension will lead to difficulties once a student reaches higher education. Our group has worked with Clara Barton Elementary School to have a better scope to why Anaheim has such a low reading comprehension percentage. Our compelling questions are, what are the effects of low reading comprehension and why do students struggle with reading comprehension?
From kindergarten to third grade, students focus on learning to read, meaning they focus on syllables and sounds and how to pronounce the words. But from fourth grade on forward, students are expected to read to learn. However, not all students transition easily or are ready to start reading and comprehending what they read. By fourth grade, students are expected to develop reading skills, while some are still struggling to sound out the words, much less understand what they read.
The scenery got crowded, and the peace and quiet, it was gone. What was gone?
Our first supporting question was, what percentage of students in Orange County meet or exceed their grade level English language arts? Through looking at the Los Angeles Times article, the national education data states that California lags behind the national average in reading and writing for 4th and 8th graders.
Our first action was to write an article for the school newspaper, Saxon Shield, to bring awareness to the effects of low reading comprehension skills. Our article included data and solutions to combat the growing numbers of students graduating with below basic reading comprehension levels. Our second level action was interacting with elementary students. We collaborated with Loera's civic engagement team and participated in a Saturday school session at Clara Elementary. During that session, we read to the kindergartners. Sandra read to these kids, and during the reading, we asked them questions to see if they understood what the reading was about. This action then prompted our Take the Lead and Read book drive, since we had the opportunity to meet with an administrator. The level 3 action that we took was starting a book drive at our school. Through our week-long book drive, we wanted to promote reading by donating books to Loera's local elementary and middle schools. We promoted the book drive online by creating a visual that was posted on various social media platforms.
So nice, so nice, I got you.
To keep track of the book donations, we had a print paper form, in addition to an online Google form that students filled out. Initially, we planned to donate books to Clara Barton Elementary School's library. Processing through the donations, however, we concluded that some books were better suited for middle school students. There was a Boston Pastis for Key Club members, a box in the library for all students, and a box in Hager for NHS. With the help of Key Club, Lower ASB, California Scholarship Federation, CSF, National Honor Society, NHS, and the student body, we raised over 100 storybooks, 80 short novels, and 120 novels.
To conclude our action plans, we were able to deliver the donated books to Clara Barton on time. Since they were on spring break, Tweet and Sandra came this past Monday. Although the vice principal, Ms. Schumer, wasn't there at the time due to a meeting, it still gave us such a sense of relief that our drive was accomplished. The books ranged from first grade to sixth grade books, so we hope that they make a great addition to their library. We are hoping that the school lets the students know of this donation and ultimately, that this lets them know that there are other students out there who are willing to help these younger students and wanting to see that these students succeed in the future. We are so grateful that so many people at Lowera donated and that Clara Barton was able to accept. For what is currently being done about this issue, here is a current elementary school, Clara Barton, and what they are doing to raise reading comprehension for their students.
So my name is Stephanie Schumate. I'm the vice principal at Clara Barton School. This is my first year at our school as the vice principal, but before this my job was a curriculum specialist at our district office specializing in English language arts. So AR is an acronym that stands for Accelerated Reading, and it is it's essentially a diagnostic reading tool that our school uses to help our kids set reading goals and gives us information about how to give them different instruction or how to motivate them better in their reading. So the way that our school uses AR is we have two components that the mother company of AR, which is called Renaissance Learning, that they have two programs and we purchase both. One of them is called Star Reading and the other one is called Accelerated Reading. And Star Reading works as like the diagnostic tool where once every, we'll say 8 to 12 weeks, our students take a Star Reading test, which is an adaptive test. So they log into their AR account on our student portal and they answer a series of questions. And if you get a lot of questions right, then it'll make your questions harder and harder because it's trying to ask you questions until the computer can figure out where your maximum threshold is for reading. The teacher then gets a report that shows the reading range for that student. So it will show us that, you know, I may have a sixth grader in my class that's reading at a 6.1, which would be sixth grade first month, to a 12.8, which would be 12th grade 8 months. So that's their reading range. And so that tells me that I can give them a book pretty much at sixth grade and above, and they're probably going to sort of be okay with that. But then it also shows me when I teach like second grade, if I have a student that's reading range is like a 0.3 to a 1.6, then that tells me that because they don't have any of their numbers in the 2 area, that they're going to struggle if I give them second grade text. So I want to give them books in their level. So what our teachers do with that reading range is they work with our librarian who has all those ranges too in the library, and that's the zone that most of our students check their books out from when they go to the library. And then after they check out their book, they read it a few times, they do some activities with it, and then they take a quiz in the computer on the accelerated reading, not Star Reading, and they take a reading quiz, and the computer asks them a series of questions. They answer, it's all multiple choice, they answer the questions, and then each book is worth a certain number of points. So big books like chapter books are gonna be worth like 3 points, 6 points, 7 points, depending on the complexity of the book. And then little easy books are worth like maybe half a point or maybe 1 point. And so our teachers work each trimester to set reading goals for students so that way they are able to know what their goal is. And then we talk to kids all the time about how are you meeting your goals, etc. So the more quizzes they take, the more likely they are to reach their reading goal.
If you're a sixth grader reading in a second grade level and you keep only reading first grade books, you're going to continue to read like a first grade student because you're not challenging yourself. So eventually, you're going to need to start reading harder books and struggling through it, and know that it's going to be okay in the end. It's going to be hard, it's going to be frustrating, but you have to keep struggling through it. My husband, who is the same age as I am, and he went to school in the whole language time too, he also did not, he wasn't a terrible reader, but he hated reading. And now that he's an adult and we talk about reading, it's because he doesn't want to read about things that he thinks are boring. So when he gets, like, if I give him a magazine about, you know, hot rods, the guy can tell me everything there is to know about a hot rod, and he can read these articles, and he loves it. He's so motivated to read it. If I give him a book about, you know, being a good friend, which is a lame example because we're adults, but he doesn't care. That's not interesting to him. He didn't get to pick that. He didn't get to choose that. That's not interesting to him. So my greatest advice when I work with struggling readers is you have to read something you want to read. And that's difficult when you're a student because your teachers most of the time pick what you are reading. But when you go to the library or you're subscribing to blogs or whatever it is that you're using as your literature, you have to be interested in it. Otherwise, who cares? And I think that we're very fortunate right now to have things like audiobooks and things like that, because it allows you to connect to text that you may not be able to read by yourself, but you're connected to this story or connected to this text that you just have to listen to it and understand.
Overall, we hope that reading comprehension for students do increase, and so does their reading level as years go on. Reading and understanding what we read takes root in everything one does, no matter if it's education-related. This is why it remains so significant. As looking at the example of elementary students, they seem to be very motivated, so we can only hope that this book donation motivates them further. Starting strong young will only help us stay strong for the future. Thank you for listening.